broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, it proved through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say,
the following broadcast is an official production of the Faulkner Sports Network.
Probably we haven't seen a first shot, but that's very
good. Oh, and bomb into screw attack. Nice. And a back air. Wow. Heck of a play by the captain. All right, so an interesting strategy there. Oh, that's it.
Oh, wow.
Oh, well, that's one way to get a kill.
So far, so good. Uh-oh, good spot dodge.
Nice.
Lovely.
Both characters are actually fairly susceptible to juggling. Dark Pit, because he's so... Oh, that's one for the highlight reel. DK, how you like a big monkey foot in your face? Good neutral air there. Tries to... Oh, and back air for the win.
Back air.
Oh, and get a command grab.
There we
nice.
Go.
Nice. The stage spike.
Good evening, folks, and thank you so much for being with us here for our production of the Faulkner Smash White Team game. This is going to be the final game of the season, so we are winding things down, but it is not the end of the season because we are playoff eligible. So this will not be our final game. It will just be the final game of the regular season, and it is against the Ringling College of Art and Design. So it's going to be Eagles versus the Rollers tonight, which is kind of a unique mascot. They have a little armadillo, and so they're the Rollers. I'm head coach Caleb Colquitt.
And I'm Darian Rogan.
And Darian's going to be here with me tonight doing his maiden voyage on commentary, which I'm very excited about. So we are going to be jumping into it feet first. You may recall that we literally just got off the air like 10 minutes ago, but we're already back. And we are ready to go. The team is ready. Both teams are signed in. We were worried that it was actually going to go over to the point to where we may not be able to, do both games at the same time, or we may not be able to do the broadcast for one of them, but we are good. We're ready to go. And we are going to be taking off here in a second. I would apologize to all of our viewers if you're here when you normally watch us on YouTube. For whatever reason, Restream is just not working for us tonight. But we are soldiering on, and we are available on Facebook and Rumble and Twitch. So if you're watching us on any of those mediums, we will have it on YouTube if you want to watch later. We just don't have it now. So let's go ahead and meet our team.
Maining Ridley, the Lieutenant, Shadow Death Guy, Connor Hagen. Maining Link, Zoinks, Grady Zink. Laying Isabel, Avarice, Logan Chalchi. Making his mark with Inkling, Crazy C, Cooper Fisher. Maining King K. Rool, Shy Guy Game, Dale Johnson. Fighting as Kazuya, Entropy, Titus King.
All right, so we're back, and you're seeing there inside Regitar USA High Res Arena Skyloft, which is where we play all of the Smash Bros, and they're just getting a lag test in right now. So we'll be starting the game here in just moments. But yeah, we'll bring you the coverage as soon as that starts. They're just finishing up that lag test, but the guys are excited, ready to finish out the season strong. And it looks like there's no lag, or at least none that I can perceive from where I am. Hopefully it's not an issue. But we'll go ahead and give you an update on what we've decided so far. Looks like the arena's set up. We did a lag test. We haven't done coin flips or bans or anything like that. So that is going to be coming up here shortly. But while we're waiting on that, we'll go ahead and let you know about when our next broadcast is going to be happening. That is going to be tomorrow, and it's also going to be the final game of the season for League of Legends. So League is going to conclude their regular season tomorrow, and that is going to be against Hartwick College, and that is going to be at 6. And actually, they could be playoff eligible as well, depending on how the numbers shake out, if they're able to win tomorrow. So they could theoretically be playoff eligible. The only game that we have of the season after that is going to be Overwatch, and unfortunately, Overwatch is not playoff eligible, but it would be really nice for them to be able to end the season off with a win, so we'll be looking for that Thursday at 6 p.m. as well. So it looks like both teams have finished their lag test, and they called heads. It is heads. So their captain has elected to ban first, and they have banned Battlefield. So we ask if that was their only ban. They only get one, don't they, for the first one?
Yes.
Yeah, they only get Battlefield for the first ban, and then we'll ban two, and then they will choose. So we'll go ahead and get that. And we already know who the starters are. I know that we did it in slightly different order than you normally do. But we've got Crazy C on Inkling. So Cooper, there's too many C names over here. Cooper's going to be going in first. And they are going to be sending in Zelda.
That's interesting.
That is interesting. I don't think we've seen a Zelda this season, have we, Darian?
I think we did.
Did we?
I think so.
On blue team?
I believe so. I believe it was like two or three games ago.
I was thinking we didn't see one on white team, but we did see one on blue. You're right. We did have one on blue team, but I was pretty sure we have not seen one on white team. So if I'm not.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Yeah, I think this is the first one for white team. So, yeah. They banned their first. We banned Final Destination and Kalos. And now they're going to pick. What will it be? Oh, yeah, Kalos is a counter pick. So, yeah, they're correct. So you can't actually ban Kalos because it's not one of the starter stages. So Connor will decide that here in a moment. We're just waiting with bated breath as to find out what we're going to be starting on. And I assume that Connor's probably letting Cooper do the counter picking, so that's probably why. But we will get underway here in a second. And by the way, just as sort of a side note, right over here next to us, we have the League team practicing. So they're getting ready for that last game tomorrow night. Should be a lot of fun. They've got actually, Rafe's not in there practicing with them. Zane is in there. I almost said Rafe because I can't see real well, and he's at the far end of the computer. But that is actually Zane, not Rafe. So his brother. And then Charlie's in there, Josh is in there, Seth is in there, not the Seth that was just here, the other Seth, Magoo. And I assume that Abby is probably logged in. So I think Rafe would be the only one that they're missing. But they're going to be playing that tomorrow. Should be a lot of fun. So, and again, do apologize to everybody. Because it looks like Restream just updated tonight. And because of that, there have been all kinds of issues going on. I'm sure that they will sort it out in the next few days. But, like, for example, for whatever reason, because Restream is also how we put in the descriptions for our videos, it's saying that this game is the Overwatch 2 game against Carroll College that happened last week. Yeah. So even on the venues where we are streaming, we're apparently not streaming with the correct we're not streaming with the correct setup. I don't know how else to say that, but we are working on it. We're trying to get that fixed. I'm not sure exactly what we need to do to fix that, but now that they have the new setup, we will try to fix that as quickly as possible. Again, not exactly sure how that's going to be. I think, if I'm not mistaken, Rumble, which has a history of being the buggiest because it's the newest platform, is actually the only one that has it right tonight. So somehow that happened to work out. Okay, so here we are. We're going into the first game. Very nice. So, yeah, it is Inkling versus Zelda. And I'm digging the North Cave theme from Final Fantasy VII we got playing in the background here. That's nice. Very nice. Great success.
See Cooper starting off with a little juggling.
Yep. A little juggling and a very yellow Zelda there, so he's getting a nice damage bonus. But Zelda's starting to figure out his movement patterns, so he's having to counter here. And the big knight coming out, the Phantom Knight. Ah, reflects the grenade, but here's the thing. It reflects the momentum, but the grenade still blows up, so she can still get hit by it.
Yep. That still didn't go that far.
It did not, no. Those grenades can actually be quite effective. Oh, wow. Is able to get the side B off, so the Din's fire being able to hit perfectly, and paint types are weak against fire types because paint is flammable. So that's what happened there. Oh, able to take out the Phantom Knight there. Faulkner now down one stock, but Cooper decided he is not going to go out quietly. Really wants to make some noise here.
He's staying aggressive. So.
That's right. You want to stay aggressive. Unfortunately, this Zelda able to zone him out some. Now, he has plenty of zoning options himself. So it's just a question of who's going to zone more effectively here. Because while Zelda tends to zone more... Oh, nice! Nice forward smash there for the kill. While Zelda tends to zone more, Inkling is much more of a hit-and-run character.
Yes. Kind of similar to Joker, almost.
Yeah, a little bit. They have similar play styles in certain ways. Joker being much more precise, whereas... Inkling has bigger, flashier hitboxes. Oh, wow, but does not account for the Phantom Knight and almost dies there. This Zelda has so many ledge guard options.
I noticed that Zelda keeps using the Phantom Knight as a decoy for...
Yes.
For bomb.
It's a pretty good counter, actually.
It is.
More effective than I would have thought. Yeah, Cooper trying hard to get that berry. You see him using roller a lot here. Luckily, he changed off of it, trying to mix it up a little bit, make this Zelda have to guess a little more. Oh, yeah. Zelda just shielded through that, and there was enough end lag to where he was able to grab and punish hard. And Zelda has very strong throws.
Yes. Okay, that was not.
I like it. Oh, able to catch him in a jab. Yeah, and this Zelda making use of those very big hitboxes, making it hard to approach. And a back throw followed up by Phantom. Can be a very powerful combo, but luckily Cooper did not panic. He just kind of like waited it out, let himself recover to low. He's been pretty good at countering knight since the first round of attacks.
Oh.
Ooh.
Little taunt there. This is a defensive game versus an offensive game.
For sure. Oh, no. Yeah. Leaves himself wide open there. Zolda just able to get behind him and then punish with a forward smash. Very effective. Able to get the kill. Faulkner now down to 9 stocks. So Ringling able to keep a 2-stock advantage over the Eagles, unfortunately. But, you know, Zolda does have a lot of power and a lot of range, but there's also several good hard counters for her. And so the question is, how is Connor going to counterpick this? What's he going to do here? And we shall find out soon. Maybe, I don't know. It's, might not. Who knows? We could just be waiting here for a while. No, there are several good options that he has here. It looks like the ones that he has checked in with for tonight is he has himself, Titus, and then, of course, Crazy Sue, who we just saw. That's Cooper. And then Shy Guy Game, so Dale on the K-Rule.
I think Dale would be a good option.
Yeah, I was going to say, I could definitely see the K-Rule being a good option here. Shadow Death Guy, I could see him doing well here as well.
Especially with the command grab.
Right, the command grab would be nice. The only thing I worry about with Ridley is he's very light, and this Zolda packs a really powerful punch, and he's big. So he's more of a juggle risk. Now, K-Rool is a juggle risk too because he's such a big target, but he has A, belly armor, and B, he's a lot heavier than Ridley, so he can survive even if he gets caught for a lot longer.
He has some ranged options as well.
That's also true, yeah. So Ridley's only real ranged option, though that command grab does have a very big range, is his neutral B. He has the plasma balls. So in theory, Ridley is not a bad pick either, but I could definitely see them going Dale here. Titus might not be the best option just because his Kazuya tends to rely very heavily on being able to super armor through things. But Zeldas are so powerful, he may not be able to. So I don't know that I would have gone Kazuya here. But, you know, who knows? We'll see. Of the options, I probably like Dale the most. But
as long as Titus can get in close and
right.
do some big damage, I think he'll be fine.
You think so?
I think so.
Okay.
But it's getting...
Oh, wow, and it looks like that's exactly what's going to happen. We've got Kazuya going in on small battlefield. So let's see if Titus can make me eat my words. I hope that it is correct. I would love to be proven wrong. I usually don't like being proven wrong, but here I'm up for it. There we go. He hit her with his eyes. Get it. Yep. There you go. Good job playing around. Winds up facing the wrong direction there. But good job playing around the Zolda. Oh, goes for the down spike, but Titus not falling for that one. And air dodges over Din's fire. Kazuya, one of the few characters that can actually air dodge after using his recovery.
Titus is still trying to get in close.
Yeah, having a hard time doing that. The Zolda has found just using down B, spamming Phantom, has been fairly effective at keeping him away. Catches him in a jab there. Going to try to use Phantom to ledge guard. Titus smartly recovering low.
Can he stay in advantage?
That is the question. What is that, Dragon Uppercut that he used to get out of that? Oh, and a quick grab by the Zelda. Like we said, Zelda has very powerful throws. Able to use back throw to get a KO there. Faulkner now down to 8 stocks. But Kazi only needs to get in one really good hit to take out this Zelda. Oh, nice up smash. Oh,
if only that had some splash damage.
Right? There we go. Nope, doesn't quite kill.
That's it.
That'll do it. Oh, doesn't go in for it. Able to avoid the dense fire and get a hit in. Very nice. Oh. Man, excellent spacing by the Zelda. Able to read what he was going to try to do off of ledge.
Oh, that's...
That's tough.
Yeah.
And able to use forward air there. Good option to avoid getting ledge trapped. Not that Kazuya does a ton of that, but... He has some options. Forward air again. Comes out very quick. Man. Oh!
Is that like a back hit? No.
That was a forward air.
Yeah, that was a forward air.
All right. Well, unfortunately, only able to take one stock there. Faulkner now down 4 stocks, but, you know, never too far away. We could send somebody in and do some cleanup damage. The ones that they currently have left on this first set are going to be Dale, Shy Guy Game, and Shadow Death Guy. So either of them could come in, and let's see. It looks like they... have not said anything yet. Probably haven't decided who they're going to be sending in. Or maybe they have. It looks like it's probably going to be Shy Guy Game, but we don't know that for sure. Because they haven't actually said on the chat yet. Oh, I take it back. They actually have. There it goes. I just had to say something, and then the internet will catch up to me and prove me wrong. So that's how that works. You have to avoid the commentator's curse. I'd rather commentator's curse this than I would the actual gameplay.
Yes.
But yeah, Shy Guy Game on K Rool. So gonna be looking for that.
I feel like K Rool can get Zelda away from him into like some good ledge guarding opportunities to come with that.
Right, and that's kind of what I was saying beforehand. I think that K Rool is actually a better matchup for this Zelda. Just because Zelda's powerful, like she has so many powerful options that it makes it hard for Kazi to take full advantage of his armor. And K. Rool, belly armor works a little bit differently than it does. Its big limiting factor is not that moves that are powerful enough that will just power through it, but the fact that it can take damage over time. And so I feel like that's a little bit better if you're playing a character that has a lot of hit, a lot of knockback, that kind of thing. So I'm thinking that K. Rool probably fares better against Zelda than Kazuya did, but we will see. And it looks like they have banned Battlefield, FD, and Small Battlefield, which means we are going to Pokemon Stadium 2.
I like to call it PlayStation 2.
Yeah, I know. I think of it every single time. I love Pokemon Stadium 2, though. That's a great game. It's one of my favorites. I love the Gym Leader Castles. That was super fun.
I never played it. So.
It's because you're young. I would I would have fought a bear to be able to play Pokemon Stadium 2 when it first came out. I was so excited. I loved Silver and Gold were my favorite generation. So. Uh-oh. Yeah, funny series of exchanges here. This Zelda really able to cake on some damage. But K. Rool doesn't have to hit very often to be able to do that himself.
Belly armor really showing its worth in this match.
Yes. It's good as gold. Almost like it is gold. Dell also doing a great job with his shield and timing that well. Oh, man. Dale got up at the wrong time there. Yeah, that probably would have worked on a lot of characters, but not K. Rool. Guy has such good recovery.
Can't really ledge guard him. It has to be from the side.
Right. And able to use dash attack there to get past Nehru's love. Oh, good throw. Able to use Blunderbuss to push her off. Gets her with the cannonball. Oh, and air dodges away. Now, luckily, Zelda has really good. Oh, wow. Man, turn the tables on that one. And the neutral air able to finally take the last stock of Zelda. So Zelda, thankfully, out of the way. But man, what a run by the Zelda. Able to take out almost three of our players single-handedly, leaving us with only four stocks. That's going to be tough to deal with. Hopefully the white team will be able to rally here and make a big comeback. But wow, that was quite a showing by her.
Yes.
So. Now you've got K. Rool with one stock left. Probably should have had two, but that unfortunate death right there at the end with being just at the perfect spot on the map to be able to get KO'd by that with just getting up at the wrong time and running right into that Phantom Knight. Man, that was tough. They are sending in... It's Z-I-G-U-A. I'm going to say Jigua. Jigua? I have no idea. I am far too white to be able to pronounce that. Onkazia. So it's going to be them, and they have we have banned Final Destination, Kalos, and Smashville, which makes sense. They're going to go town and city.
Okay.
No.
I'm not a fan of either of
those I stages. Am also not a fan of Town and City. What is your favorite stage, Darian, of the Legals?
Halabastion.
Really?
Yes.
I thought you would have said Kalos, but Halabastion makes sense. I do see you pick that one a lot.
One, I'm a Kingdom Hearts fan, too. I just like the one platform.
Right? I decided to go Kingdom Hearts tonight. I don't know if you noticed, but I, too, love the Kingdom Hearts. And man, in 2037, when Kingdom Hearts 4 finally comes out, it's going to be awesome.
Yes.
Hopefully I'll live long enough to see Kingdom Hearts 5. Probably not.
All right. Another Kazuya here.
Yes. So Kazuya is able to power through a lot of things, but he's ooh, belly armor is really being pushed to its limit here. But luckily, Dale has played against Titus quite a bit. This is probably going to help him. He knows the matchup fairly well.
For sure.
Oh, and I love it when he shoots them out of the blunderbuss and they wind up hitting the cannonball that he just launched out of the blunderbuss. So funny.
It lasts so long, it stays there, even when you think it's gone.
Yeah, it's the world's slowest cannonball. It moves at like 3 miles an hour. Ooh. Yeah, that's going to be game. Unfortunately, Dale not able to take a stock. That's the thing about Kazi. You only have to get caught in one move, and man, the dude just hits like a tank. It's so easy for him to KO. Even a heavy character like K. Rool is not safe. And so, unfortunately, that means that Faulkner is now down by 6 stocks. It's going to take, it's not impossible, but it's going to take some heavy lifting to bring him out of this one. And so that leaves us with Shadow Death Guy as the anchor. So it's going to be Ridley versus Kazuya. Now, again, Kazuya may be somewhat of an advantage because the guys on white team have played Titus so much with Kazuya that it does give them some insight into how the character is played and how it works. And it looks like they're going to a small battlefield.
That'll be interesting.
It's like Battlefield, but smaller.
Then there's the forbidden big battlefield.
Yes. Big battlefield, no. You don't want big battlefield.
No.
It's like that old meme. It's like, you're going to have a bad time. You're going to have a bad time. You don't want big battlefield. All right. So we will be getting underway here in just a second. I do think that the Ridley, I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of things that Ridley does that can counter some of the things that Kazuya does, but because one of Ridley's biggest weaknesses is that he's so big that he can become combo and juggle food.
Yeah.
But Kazuya doesn't really utilize that, but part of that is because Kazuya is so good at getting combos regardless of how big you are, so it's kind of a weird situation to be in. Ooh.
Ridley can get the spacing.
Yep. That's going to be crucial. Oh! Man, in the star KO. Ooh! Electric Wing God Fist. Which is far too long a name for a combo. Yes. Oh, man.
Kazuya just being able to rack up damage so fast.
Yep. Oh, wow. And again, that is one thing that he has an advantage over. Because he's just able to get, especially under platform, Kazuya has so many good under platform options. He does like flat stages.
Yes, especially Final Destination.
Uh-huh. But he does actually have plenty of good under platform options. Now, that doesn't work as well against Ridley because he has such good recovery. I probably would have thrown it in a different way, but not a bad option. Oh, and completely misses with the command grab, and unfortunately Kazuya able to get behind. There it is. Ridley back air. That's what you need. At 199 damage, Ridley able to take that stock. But unfortunately, the Kazuya up air able to do its work. Ooh, man. That is scary. So, unfortunately, Faulkner not able to take set one. Now they are going to have to win both sets back-to-back in order to win this game. Certainly doable, certainly something that we can do. We have lost the first set before and then come back and win the next two, but it is a big mountain to climb, especially with how good that Zelda was. Mm-hmm. So hopefully the guys are going to be able to pull this one together and take down the Zelda and then subsequently the Kazuya. But I do think that they're going to have to play a little bit differently in order to do that. Going to have to be smart about who they pick first. And this is the problem with losing the set before you see all the other guys, is now you're in an awkward situation because they've seen all of your players. You haven't seen all of theirs. And so it's much easier for them to pick a first person to go in.
And they, you don't know if they're going to send in a different character.
Right. They
first.
They could send in somebody that you have no idea who it is. So, like, if you try to counterpick one of their two, they could pick something that hard counters an option that you might have. And so you're just playing with a lot less info than the other team does when you lose the first set. All right, they are bringing out the Zelda again. Makes sense. They've decided to send in Avarice on Isabelle.
Okay.
So we got Nacho coming in on Isabelle. Yes, it is true. He is Nacho. Nacho! But yeah, so good to see Nacho jumping in. They've banned Battlefield. And to answer your question, Connor, yes, counterpick does still apply since it's the first round. So, you know, that's really a testament to my skill that I can both coach and broadcast at the same time. You're welcome, America. And then now my producer is giving me sass. Anyway. So here we go. We've got that matchup coming up. I do like the Isabelle pick. I think that's a much, much better pick for
they
going against the Zelda. I
haven't seen Isabelle yet.
Right. So that is something that is better for us. Isabelle has so many options to control. Like, stage control is her thing. And with Zelda, you saw a lot of stage control, a lot of just being able to position people where she wanted, using Phantom to force them to avoid it, and then being able to do whatever she needed to do once they reacted to Phantom. So, you know, we'll see. We'll see. But Isabelle, I do think, is a much, much better counter pick for Zelda than any of the four that we had earlier. So I do think that that's a better option. So we'll see how that goes. All right, so we're going to be... They have banned Town and City and Smashville. So I would think that means Small Battlefield or Pokemon Stadium 2.
I could see them going Small Battlefield.
Yeah.
PS2 is not a bad option.
Small play. Not please, play. That's how they write it. I don't make the news. I just report it. All right. So here we go. We're about to get underway here. And here we go. Isabelle versus Zelda. All right. Brand new game. Brand new attitude. That's another thing, too. Zelda does really well against larger characters because she has such big hitboxes. Mm-hmm. Isabelle, much smaller character. One of the smaller ones. Ha, we'll dust you to death. All right, nice use of slingshot there. Tries to combo into Turnip, not quite able to pull that one off. This Zelda really knows what they're doing. DI-ing in specific ways to avoid that. Oh, and gets the first kill, so Faulkner with their first lead of the evening. Shielding through Phantom there. Does get hit by Phantom. Phantom does a lot of damage.
They seem to really like Phantom.
I have noticed that. Oh, yeah. So a little bit risky going in against that Zelda. Probably would have been better to hold back a little bit, stay out of range of that forward air. Can you pocket Phantom?
Huh.
I don't think so. That would be awesome, though.
That would be cool.
Isabelle can pocket most things. Nice. Tries to combo into forward air. Zelda's able to get out of that.
Isabelle trying to pocket.
She can pocket Din's fire, so. That's the thing about Fishing Rod, though. It's so effective and it's so quirky, but if it misses, there's a lot of end lag on it.
That's why placement is key.
Yes. Just like in fishing.
And patient.
Yes. You go fishing much, Darian?
Not much. I do enjoy it, though.
Nacho goes fishing for combos. Nice. Little neutral air action going on there. Ooh, and finally goes down. That Isabel at a very high damage. Logan doing a really, really good job of just keeping her off. Oh, and able to launch her. Nice. Nice. Is able to use the Lloyd to get a win there. Ooh.
That's such a powerful attack.
Yeah, forward air is really nice. I didn't even see what hit Isabel there. So Zelda... Oh, Zelda has started to figure out some of Isabel's patterns. Nacho's really going to have to use some mix-up here. Tried to grab the Den's Fire. Doesn't quite make it. Just catches with the Den's Fire right on Isabel's feet. And now both players playing much slower and safer than they had previously. Both just trying to take this last stock. Oop. Probably should have shielded through that instead of trying to air dodge it. Nice get up attack. Oh, and interrupts the Phantom, which sets up that nice combo. Little juggle.
Oh. Slingshot keeping the distance.
Yep. Oh, no. Unfortunately, attacks on shield, and when Zelda grabs out of shield, very quick grab and a very strong back throw. So even though Nacho really started that out dominating, Zelda started figuring out his patterns, and then it became a much more even matchup. Unfortunately, when it started to even out, the Zelda was able to just get that. And really, that was one that at the end could have gone either way. The Zelda and Isabel were both playing super, super well. But unfortunately, he attacked on shield, and Zelda was just able to use that in lag to her advantage, and that's what gets the kill. And also just because of the position, because if he had been, you know, a little further in the middle of the stage, probably wouldn't have killed. But where they were right on the ledge. So, fortunately, that's how it goes. But still, Faulkner in a way better position right now than they were. They did lose the lead. They are down by a stock now, but in a way better position than we were set one. So, we will go ahead and send in, it looks like, Shy Guy.
Okay.
So he is going to be on the K rule. So make way for Killer Croc. About to come in, hopefully to the swamp. We will see.
Don't want to be in that swamp.
Nope.
Nope. Don't want to be in that swamp at all. The gator get you.
That's my poor attempt at a Cajun accent.
I'll just take him to Florida. You know.
Yeah. Well, see, what I do is I channel my inner Ed Orgeron. Do you remember him? The former coach of LSU?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, love that guy. He was the most entertaining coach in the SEC because you would watch him do a press conference and you would turn on closed captioning and you couldn't understand a word he was saying, and you could tell the closed captioning people couldn't either because they would put out sentences that didn't make any sense. Like,
and I was down the four line. Go Tigers.
That's all you can understand out of it. It was so entertaining. I know that he's a football coach and I'm an esports coach, but I aspire to be that level of entertaining, even if I don't have speech that no one can understand. Another great one, Steve Spurrier. I miss Steve Spurrier. He used to coach at South Carolina. And the thing that was so great about him is when he would do the press, he would tell you the truth, which was hilarious. They asked him a question. I was like, well, coach, why are you behind at this game at halftime? I was like, well, they scored more points than us. It was just, he'd say it deadpan. It was so good. All right, here we go. Zelda has to take two stocks here. Dale gets to keep his three. And as you can see, we are on Pokemon Stadium 2. Not Pokemon Stadium 1, in case you were confused. Oh, no! Oh, no! Luckily, he's at low enough damage that it's not fatal, but not what you want. You don't want to be breaking them shields that early. Nice. So, this is Zelda doing a fantastic job of spacing the K rule.
Yes.
And Dale also seemingly having a little bit of trouble attracting this Zelda with his eyes. Because you'll notice there were several times where the Zelda would either get behind him or he would just move in the wrong direction. I don't know if he was trying to read there and just missed it or what. But this Zelda clearly very good with movement. There you go. Get him, Dale. Oh, that Phantom Knight is going to be feeling that one in the morning. Doesn't work. K-Rool has good recovery.
Dale having to watch his timing coming on ledge.
Yes.
With all the projectiles.
Oh, just misses it. I think the Zelda figured out that that's one of the things he likes to do. Tries to reflect it back.
Okay.
There we go. Up smash. Attaboy, Dale.
With a Super Mario question block.
Yes. Ha. There we go. I do love the question block. My friend got me a little light up Mario question block. And when you press it, it makes the coin noise.
That's cool.
And when you press it again to turn it off, it does the Mario death noise. It's just sitting on my bookshelf, so it's not actually serving any purpose other than just entertaining me. Whenever I walk by it, I'll hit it and then turn it off again. That's the thing about being a guy, especially a gamer. We're easily amused. Little things can amuse us.
Yeah.
We're simple creatures. So producer Liz is agreeing with us. She's like, yes, y'all are simple. We get it. All right, so we're going to see the Kazuya again. So they're going in the exact same order as they did last time. Which, you know, I get it. If you win a set and it's really close, you probably need to mix up the order. Mm-hmm. If you win a set and you win big and you only had to show two of your players, I don't see why you don't go the same route and just see if you can get that win again, because that gives you so much confidence and you can play that really well. And so I would not blame them for mixing it up and showing two players that we haven't seen before.
Plus, they had a much better start than the first round. Mm-hmm. So.
But, you know, strategically, I totally get why they would want to do this. So Faulkner now, with only a one-stock deficit, Dale can definitely bring this back around if he can play around this Kazuya. Yeah, and already, K-Rool at 92. Kazuya's combos just do so much so quickly. Oh, and a zero to death. Man. Not what you want to see. Get him, Dale. Use your freaky eye tick to trick him out. Ooh. That was a little scary. Uses the down spike under platform. I did not know. Well, I mean, Kazuya's pretty tall. I guess it makes sense. All right, now we go. Dale starting to read some of these attack patterns. Hopefully it's not too little too late. He can make something happen here. Oh!
That's nasty.
Ooh. Ooh, that was a true combo too, wasn't it?
Yes.
Jeez.
Sadly.
Well, that is the problem with Kazuya. I mean... a lot of his combos, he can just, if he knows what he's doing, he's nasty. So they have actually said, are we going to get the Kazuya Ditto? Because they know that one of our players is Kazuya. I don't know. Do you go for the Kazuya Ditto here, Darian?
It's like, you wouldn't want to be in a win condition.
Right.
So it's just like, it just depends. Because like,
honestly, I think they go for it. And here's why. The Ridley really struggled against Kazuya, and now that we're a whole three stocks behind, which is deeper than we've been this round so far, this is our biggest deficit of the night. If you throw in the Ridley, even if you get the best case scenario, you're probably going to at least lose a stock or two, which granted you probably will do with Kazuya as well, but I feel like because Kazuya has way more survivability than Ridley, because the thing is, Ridley has good survivability, but it's only because he has such good recovery. Kazuya hits you so hard that recovery doesn't matter a lot of the time.
And the only person that can hit it as hard as Kazuya.
So I think you go for the Kazuya Ditto. Nope, they decided to go with Ridley. Okay, well, maybe Connor has decided he wants a crack at this. You know what? I'm going to take this. Take this, Kazuya. I've played this magic before. I know what I'm doing. And they're going to be on the small battlefield. So hopefully there is no Kazuya Ditto tonight, because that would mean that we emerge victorious from this, Kazuya, and hang on to at least one of Connor's stocks. Oh, no. This is not looking good. Come on, you can get out of this. Come on, Connor. He's got it.
Oh,
almost did. Ooh. And that's going to be another stock loss for Faulkner. There we go. Now Connor getting in some licks.
Oh,
and gets the spike.
Okay.
There he goes. Man, what a turnaround for the lieutenant. There we go. Using the old Ridley flow chart. You've seen the Ridley flow chart, Darian. You know what I speak of. Oh, man. I do too, and it's so sad because Connor played that stock so well, but it only takes one really good hit from Kazuya, and he kills Ridley at like 80. There we go. The dreaded Ridley back air.
Oh.
Oh, man. Okay. Nope, he's still alive.
Good DR.
He's at 146, but he is still alive. Good punish. Oh. No. Dude, such a good showing by Connor, but not able to seal the deal. Those combos were so true. That was one of the swingiest matches I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Because it was like, oh, Kazuya's owning him. And there's like, oh, Ridley's owning him. And it just went back and forth. Man,
all it took was one attack to just sway the whole direction.
It really did, and it's unfortunate because Connor played that so well. It was the two kills that he got, they weren't just flashy and entertaining to watch. Like, they were high skill kills, but unfortunately it wasn't enough. I love this. I do like the attitude we're getting from from Ringling. They're like, let's go FD, let's get it. It's like, because he knows that the other Kazuya is going to want FD too. Yes. So, okay. They panicked there for a second because they didn't change the stage. Okay, there we go. Yeah, we're on Final Destination. Okay.
Your favorite stage.
I do love it. Simplicity is beautiful, Darian. It really is. And here we go. Kazuya versus Kazuya. Right on. All right. So Titus has now had several stocks to observe this Kazuya. Nice. This is really a game of shirts and skins. Or suits and skins, I guess.
You got a business major Kazuya.
And PE major Kazuya. Nice. Able to read that up B. Okay. There it is. So it turns out Arkazi is better. I mean, it was only one stop, but that's what I'm going with.
They won the Kazuya ditto. They got it.
They got their Kazuya ditto.
They got it.
Did not work out in their favor. So here's the thing. Titus has a very big hill to climb. He has to take at least two stocks for every stock they take off of him. And we have no idea who their other players are. But here's the thing. Titus has gone on 7-8 stock runs before, so if anyone can do it, it's Titus. So, it looks like, oh, did he?
Okay.
Okay.
That's
not what I was expecting.
That's out there.
That is different. Now, granted, Diddy's kind of a different character no matter what, but, you know, you've got your Zelda, you've got your Kazuya. This was looking like a very sort of stereotypical college team, and they're like, "Yeah, we're gonna throw out Diddy." All right, you do you. But yeah, we got the Diddy matchup. Now, Titus has not played a lot of Diddy, but Diddy is relatively easy to kill, especially for somebody that hits as hard and has as good a launch as Kazuya. Now, to be fair, Diddy does have a recovery that's somewhat hard to handle, but it is good.
Yes.
And so he's not going to be able to just like Gates of Hell like he would with Cloud or somebody like that, so he can't get a quick kill that way. He's just going to have to punch really, really hard.
He'll be able to space the Kazuya as well because he can move a lot faster.
Mm-hmm.
That's something that I believe he will definitely do in this matchup.
Yeah, so they're going to go to small battlefield. So I can see why. I mean, I would love to go back to Final Destination. I'm sure Titus would too. I'm actually surprised by. I mean, small battlefield makes sense for Diddy. Diddy has some range options. He's mostly just a shenanigans character though.
Yeah. And banana.
I'm gonna throw bananas.
Oh.
Yeah, so Diddy's kind of a combination of, like, Mario-esque ladder combos and weird off-brand attacks that do weird things.
I can see it. He's really relying on that banana.
He is. He uses that banana a lot. He protects it like a son. Oh, trying to shield through with Kazuya. Not the best play. Oh my. So this Kazuya really just wants to go nowhere near. Does get the monkey face. But you can tell his strategy is just like, I don't want to be anywhere near this Kazuya. And there it is. Fare thee well, tiny monkey. I will say the tripping mechanic, it affects everybody, but I wonder if it like is specifically effective against Kazuya. So, able to get the forward smash, and now it's back to 0-0 with two stocks.
Super armor on that.
Yep. Just kind of powers through it. And uses his own mechanic against him.
Give him a taste of his own mess.
Hey! There we go. Get him, Titus. If Titus can go into this next round with two stocks, that is a very winnable matchup.
Yes.
Now, we don't know who he's going to be playing against, but with Kazuya, you know, being down a stock is obviously less than ideal, but you can kill pretty quickly with Kazuya, so. Ooh, man. Look at that shield pressure. He almost got him. Playing the monkey face. Let's go a shield just a second too soon there.
Oh.
Well.
Got him.
Well, that is not. It does. Woo. I was careful there. I wasn't sure because I know it was close. It was right on the border of whether that killed or not. But, yeah, Titus taking care of business, getting things done, and now Faulkner back within striking distance, only down by a stock. Attaboy, Kazuya. So Entropy really doing yeoman's work tonight. If he's able to win this one, he will definitely be the MVP of the first round.
Yes, for sure.
I don't want to detract from the work that the other guys did, though, because Connor just played a fantastic round there, being able to come back like he did. And Dale really put in a lot of good work, too. So we will see. Let's see. Wii Fit.
Oh.
I don't really know this matchup. I'm going to be honest. Wii Fit has a lot of gimmicky stuff, kind of like Diddy Kong. It's so weird because the first two on their team were like just kind of normalish kind of picks, and they're like, oh, we got Wii Fit and Diddy Kong. It's like, it was like the clown makeup comes on more. And I'm not saying that like is in a demeaning way, but just like those are very goofy, quirky, kind of clownish characters. Normally when people play them, they're the kind of people that like just kind of messing with people. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. They're still good characters. You can still get kills with them, but they're just kind of a little, as Kramer would say, out there. So,
Wii Fit Trainer's side B is a great ledge option.
Oh, for sure. I didn't think so until we played someone that was really skilled with it, and we couldn't get around it all game. So it looks like we're going to Pokemon Stadium 2. It's not a bad option for Kazuya. It's a fairly flat stage. It has fairly close sidewall, so he'll be able to kill at low damage. I think that Pokemon Stadium 2 is actually a pretty good place for him to be able to win with a stock disadvantage. So we will see. Come on, Eagles. He has to go for the corner. All right. So now that the stretching is done. Nice start for Titus. Able to get in a couple of jab combos. All right. Now Wii Fit Trainer starting to play the juggle game, which she loves. She's really good at that. Has a lot of options in the air. And twice now, just kind of running right into Soccer Ball, trying to get around the projectiles. Oh, man, that came close to hitting, too. Yeah, recovers a little high there. Not sure that he had a better option, just saying that as a matter of fact. Oh, man, rolls right into Salute the Sun. All right, now you can tell Titus a little bit more nervous and cautious about his approach game. Not sure exactly what to do with the Wii Fit Trainer. If he can pick up these patterns, though, he can really do some damage fast. There you go. Look, Mom, I can combo with one hand. Yeah, launches the laser a little quick. And what you were talking about there, that soccer ball side B, such a good...
Ooh,
and uses the reflect. Woo! I love it. Oh, man, gets up at the wrong time, and that's going to be it for Faulkner. Unfortunately, not able to take the set. Well, that's unfortunate. So Faulkner's regular season there is going to end in a loss. Not able to take a set tonight, but a really good game. And, you know, Titus really showing out with the Kazuya. And even though Connor was not able to take more stocks than he lost, you got to be impressed with the effort that he put out there. Some of the most impressive gameplay we've seen from him all year. So Faulkner, unfortunately, not able to close out the season on a high note. But here's the thing. None of that matters because as much as we'd like to have more wins, more checks in the W column going forward, we made it into the playoffs. Yes. And once you're in the playoffs, anything can happen. We can still win a championship here if we play this smart. And we've now seen all of our opponents and can prepare better because we got game footage on all of them. Mm-hmm. So we'll be able to move forward on this. they're actually requesting fun side note. They're actually requesting to stay in the lobby. They want Kazuya to play against the Diddy because they're wanting to basically rematch. But that's fun. Yeah, they seem like good sports, a good team, a very good natured team, which we like to see. But we're going to go ahead and call it there. We're going to go ahead and go into the post game show. Unfortunately, Faulkner comes up a little bit short tonight with Ringling taking both sets. Faulkner losing to the Rollers by a score of 2-0. We will be back with the post game show.
I wanted to take my career to a higher level, right, so I searched for an MBA program that fits my schedule, that's accredited, and aligns with my Christian values. I found the perfect MBA at Faulkner University. Faulkner's MBA program consists of 10 5-week courses completely online, and the quality of instruction is excellent. Imagine how earning your MBA degree can help boost your career and get you to where you want to be. Visit faulkner.edu/advance to learn how you can get started.
Faulkner University's online executive MBA program is now accepting applications. Earn your Master of Business Administration in as little as a year. Advance your career and apply today at faulkner.edu.
Earn your online Master's of Science in Management from Faulkner in 1 year. With a focus on HR management, leadership and ethics, and strategic management, you'll gain the skills to succeed. Apply today at faulkner.edu.
My name is Mike Carriage, and I teach computer science at Faulkner. Computer science at Faulkner is dramatically changing right now. It's an exciting time to be here. We're adding new students, which is exciting for all of us, but we're also growing in the content in which we deliver. We're adding new courses, we're adding new curriculums. It's a time that things seem to be really exciting and things seem to be really changing rapidly inside of our field. Computer science will always be a rapidly evolving field. Everything from artificial intelligence to cybersecurity will always drive us to excellence. But here at Faulkner, we embrace that change as opposed to ignore it. Many of our students find their niche in the computer science world by coming here, and that's what we hope to really drive the love of computer science into our students here. I'm telling you, of any place you want to be to learn computer science, Faulkner is the place to be right now.
Welcome back, folks. Thanks so much for being with us here for our production of Smash Bros. Faulkner White's game versus Ringling College. Unfortunately, the Eagles do come up just a tad shy, even though it came down to the wire in that second match. First set didn't go as well, but the second set went much, much better. Unfortunately, Faulkner just is not able to come up with the W tonight. The Rollers do defeat us by a score of 2-0. But we are here with the leader of the White team, the Lieutenant, Connor Hagen. How you doing, Shadow Death Guy?
I've been doing all right. I heard you guys were doing pretty good over here. The commentary was
different.
Yeah.
The sleep deprivation has set in.
And you also had a guest star up here.
Well, we did. We had Darian up here, so that was a lot of fun as well. So he did a good job on his first time doing commentary. But I do want to talk to you about the game and some of the things that were going on over there. So first set seemed like really everybody was struggling against that Zelda. and you were only able to see the Zelda and the Kazuya, what were the adjustments that you made in the second set? Because it wasn't that they changed anything, because they ran exactly the same two people in the same order as the second one. So how were you able to make a difference and be able to get all the way to having them down to... Wait, did they get down to their last stock, or did they have two left?
I think they had two left.
I think that is correct, but basically we brought it down to the wire in the second one regardless. Yeah. So what was the difference there that you guys did?
Well, one part of it was the internet lag was rough, and I think we just got used to it by the second round. And I also felt that Logan worked better as a trapper than Cooper as a hit and run.
Yes.
Because Zelda can just punish it running up super easy with her counter.
Mm-hmm.
However, she was not punishing Logan as well as she could have until the very end.
Right. Well, Logan definitely did come in clutch, playing much better against the Zelda. And, you know, that's not necessarily a commentary on the skill of the players. Logan just has a character that plays way better against the style of play that Zelda was using. And mm-hmm. so that definitely was a smart move by you deciding to substitute in, because as good as Cooper is, he would have been much better served playing someone else.
Yeah.
Just couldn't do much against that Zelda. And sometimes that happens. Sometimes you just get a bad matchup. As Ridley, you understand. Sometimes that happens.
Yes. Most of the roster.
Well, you make it work though, but let's actually talk about that. That's a good segue into my next question. You know, you struggled a lot in that first set, but in the second set, you just kind of, clutched up and was able to make a lot of noise. As Ridley, what was it that you changed that made such a drastic difference?
In the first game, I was just trying to throw out Nair wherever. In the second game, I actually held shield longer and then would Nair immediately after. Because he would just be right on it, except for the Electric Wind Godfist, which has almost no end lag on shield. Just punishes not safe moves.
And combos into itself, which is just ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah,
and a lot of it just came down to muscle memory. So like I said before, the lag was kind of rough. It was really hard to react to a lot of stuff that was going on.
Mm-hmm.
But the down throw combo, I learned that one straight from John, and it just became muscle memory at this point.
Mm-hmm. Well, it did look really really good, and like you were saying, that spike into down, man, that was that's one for the highlight reel for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And then also, I got to ask you about this. Titus kind of goes on a tear there. Do you think that it would have been smarter to send him in instead of yourself against the Kazuya and then, like, use you as the backup? I know that it's easy to, like, hindsight's 20/20, but do you think that would have been smarter, or do you like the fact that you actually went in and kind of tore up the Kazuya a little bit?
I think I did it better the way I played it, because if I had used Titus and he had lost two stocks but still beat the Kazuya, I don't think I would have been able to beat the Diddy Kong or the Wii Fit.
Ah, okay. Well,
because Diddy Kong can just punish Ridley for
almost
anything.
Yeah.
Then Wii Fit can just ledge camp the whole time.
Yeah, that's true. So, you know, one of Ridley's strong suits is that he's very good off the edge of stage or in the air.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is, Wii Fit has, I would say that there are a few that have better aerials than her, like...
Wii Fit specials are just really good in the air as well.
They are. Like, her toolkit is just extremely varied and can punish, especially considering how big a body Ridley has. So,
and how light he is, yeah.
Yeah, so I actually, I don't know if you heard over here, we're paying attention. Probably weren't. It's probably better that you didn't. I was actually thinking you'd do the Kazuya ditto, but you're right that because that Kazuya can kill... it's such low damage, even another Kazuya, mm-hmm. it may have been smarter to be able to just throw in Ridley and then have Kazuya try to power through the rest of the roster when you're down like that. But mm-hmm. Either way, a great performance. It's a shame that it came up a little bit short. Y'all came within an eyelash of rolling in that last one. But a sour note to end the season on. But you know what? The thing is, the season continues on because we're in the playoffs. So
we are in the playoffs.
Looking forward to that. Is there anything, before we go, anything you're going to do working with the team to try to prepare for the playoffs, since you will have already, you'll be playing against primarily against opponents that you've already seen.
Mm-hmm.
So is there anything that you're going to do to try to prep for that?
I think that we might just run a lot more online games. I'm going to bring this to Josh. We should run more online games during practice instead of our 2-1 out setup that we've been doing, because that's nice and all, but we only know our matchups against each other and not other characters.
Yeah, and unfortunately, that is something that, as a coach, I'm trying to rectify right now, because right now we only have two online stations. We have four Smash stations, but we only have two that are actually online compatible. And if you are playing 1v1s and online, that means that instead of two people getting to practice, you have one person practicing.
Yep.
That's very difficult when you have a team of 12.
It is.
So maybe what we need to do is we need to split up, like we did last year, split up one white team and one blue team practice in the week. And since we don't have to share the arena with any of the other teams after this, that might be easier to do, because they'll still have practice, but we can give priority to y'all since, you know, they will be out of season by that point. All right. So sounds good going forward, and we're going to have to get ready for the playoffs, which, like I said, if history is any teacher, they will let us know in about a week or so. All the games in this week. So they could let us know as early as Monday, but if I had to guess, probably a little bit later than that, and then we'll have our first game, if I had to guess, about two Mondays from now. So we will keep you aware of the situation whenever we find out what's going on there. So hopefully that is sooner rather than later, but be sure to check all of our social media. We're on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, basically all of the social media sites that anybody of report uses. We're on them, so be sure to check those out and see what our schedule is looking like. And not only is this the first time we've ever had a Smash team make the playoffs, we've had two. So that is a really big deal. So be sure to check our social media, and we will let you know the schedules for those. Also, we do have another broadcast happening tomorrow that will close out the season. We are not playoff eligible whether we win or lose tomorrow, but it would be really nice to end the season on a high note and be able to take away a win for League of Legends tomorrow. I know the team's working really hard on that. They're in there practicing right now. So it would be really nice to see that. So be sure to check that out. We have a game against Hartwick College. So it's going to be Eagles versus Hawks. That takes place at 6 p.m. tomorrow on November the 5th. And then we also have a game 7:30 for Overwatch. So we have a Overwatch game Thursday at 7:30. So be sure to check that out as well. That is going to be it for us this evening. A special thanks to everybody that was helping with the broadcast this evening. For Liz Anderson, my producer, we're glad to see her back and that she's feeling better, because she actually didn't do any production last week because she was feeling lousy. We're certainly glad to see her feeling better and back up on her feet, because we need her.
Yeah.
She runs a lot of the stuff around here. It makes my job easier when she's here. And also our color commentator, who of course was Darian Rogan, doing a fantastic job on his maiden voyage as a color commentator. So we thank him for doing that and being willing to step up for that as well. And mainly just because I was wildly sleep deprived and needed somebody else to help me with it.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
Appreciate my staff and the people here we have that make all of this possible for you, the audience. So that's going to be it for us tonight. I'm, of course, your head coach, Caleb Colquitt, saying so long from Red Guitar USA Hi-Rez Arena. Be sure to check back with us tomorrow at 6 p.m. for that League of Legends game against Hartwick. Until then, stay the course, friends.
The preceding broadcast was an official presentation of Faulkner University. It may not be redistributed without the express written consent of the Faulkner University Athletic Department. Red Guitar USA Hi-Rez Arena is sponsored by Red Guitar USA. The national anthem was performed by the Faulkner University Chorus. If you would like to learn more about the Faulkner Esports program, visit our official website at FaulknerEagles.com or follow us on Discord, Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, and Instagram for all the latest news and events. Thank you for watching, and Soar Eagles!